Let's teleport player between dimensions and inside the dimension using our player teleporter item. Hello everyone, this is Ali Reza. Welcome to the Mentor Code Lab. Player teleporter was something like our tuner item, and we neglected it until now. However, the interesting thing is that for player teleporter, we didn't need events. I just forgot that I had this item until now. And honestly, I was thinking about putting the code between the episodes and not talking about it in front of the monitor. When I looked into the code, I said, wait a minute, there is something there that I think people should know, and it's useful to have it in front of the camera. And that is why I'm recording this video right now. If you take a look at teleporter for player and compare it to the tuner item, you will see that most of the code is the same. For example, use on block is almost identical to the tuner item. And by the way, the append tooltip and hasGlint is the same. Output coordinates to the chat is the same compared to tuner item. However, there are few to-dos that added in both classes, both in tuner item and my player teleporter, because I encountered something interesting. When I was writing the tuner item, I was thinking like, okay, I'm putting this position under this key as an NBT and then as the custom data component on the item, and I'm retrieving the same thing. However, during my R&D, I encountered a problem. And this problem can happen only when you are doing R&D. Basically, the key was different the very first time I was putting the information on the block. When I was recording the position on the NBT, I was using another key. And then I stopped the game. I came back. Whenever I was trying to just open the board and look at my inventory, I was crashing the game. The problem was that inside append tooltip, I was looking to get this new key, and the position was written on the NBT using a different key. So the item in my hand had a glow and glint, and if I would click on the entities, they would teleport. But the moment I was opening my GUI and it was going to append the tooltip, this was the place that I was using a different key and the game would crash. Although in final product, when you are using all the same key all over the place, you wouldn't see something like this happen. However, it's a good thing to have some sanity check. Also, if you note here, the get is telling you that, hey, it's using optional.get without isPresent check. It means that we should say if NBT helper dot to block pose isPresent, then do this. Or we can negate this and we say return, and it should work. And you don't get this error on optional.isPresent anymore. However, now we have something here. Replace is empty. Can be replaced with is empty. And it should work, because if you look, it says if a value is not present, returns true. Otherwise, false. And basically it says if it's not present, it's the same thing. If a value is not present, then return. And I will keep this part as the sanity check, copy it, and I will have to do it again here. So I should have to say if this return action result dot, I will pass here. You should take note that the keys should be the same. So that's the sanity check on the tuner item. Done. Coming back here, now we want to finish the code on the player teleporter. However, before that, I will add the same sanity check here and I will return. Take note, this time the key is different, teleporter.pose. Okay, teleporter.pose. Now let's finish our code for the usage on entity. Now remember, here we are not using on entity, but we are calling the use method because we want to handle things when the player is using the item. Something that I want to mention before I continue the code is that if you so want to, you can take these keys outside of here and into something like reference. So you can have another public static class, like public static class, and we call it keys. And here you will have a bunch of public static final strings. For example, public static final string tuner key, public static final string tuner teleporter key. And as you see, the IntelliSense gave me some hints, but those are not correct. So this one is the player teleporter. This is the key. And now I can replace any instance of this io.teleporter.pose with calling the keys.teleporter.pose. Keys.teleporter key. And same thing will be used all over this class for every method call that we have for the teleporter pose. And of course, now I need to make sure that it is covering the pause, because later, as you see, we are using dimensions as another key. This way, we make sure that we won't have any typos here and there, and everything is okay. I will do that between the episodes. So let's continue our code with the very first thing, that is a sanity check. But here we should return supercall.use world user hand. And that's it. When we get here, we make sure that we have a pose. But before that, here I want to check if NBT equals to null or it's empty, then return the supercall. Right now we made sure that we have NBT, we have the pause, and this is the dimension. Now we can move forward. So we say Minecraft server, server equals to user.getServer. No, it should be world.getServer. Then we have registry key of type world, we call it stored key, equals to registry key.of keys.word, and this needs to be changed, and instead of the, and this is registry keys.word, id of the dimension. Now we will talk about this registry key and registry keys and what is going on here in another video, but right now it's sufficient to say that I got the registration key of the dimension from Minecraft registry system. And if I call stored key equals to null, again, we want to call the super and return. We didn't get the proper dimension here. Then we say teleport target. We call it target equals to new teleport target. And as you see, it gets a word, a pause, and then the other things. So word is, of course, word.getServerWord. Actually, on top, we have the server. We can use that. So server. The position, now that we have the server, we go with get world of the stored key, because the server is just the client or the server thread, and we go with get world and a stored key. Now it says that you should make sure that server is not null. If I add it, it adds assert server not equals null. Now this is a wrong code. We should say if server equals to null, again, we want to return that super. So I will cut this part. I will come back here and I will say or server equals null. And that would get rid of that error or warning here. Okay, for the pause, this is a block position that we should direct ourselves toward. This is the position that we want to teleport into. So we use vector 3D, as the D here is double. And we say pose.getX, blah, blah, blah. But let's take a look. For the Y, we should add plus one here, because we want to go up, and that's it basically. We just use F1.0F and 0.5F. Okay, now the velocity. For the velocity, we say new vector 3D of 0, comma, 0, comma, 0. This is the velocity of 0, means that we are not having any velocity when we are teleported. Finally, user.getYaw. And for the pitch, we say user.getPitch. And finally, it says post dimension transition. Now we say teleport target.noop, means no operation after the teleportation. And that's our target. Now that we have the target, we can teleport ourselves. We say if user.getWorld.get registry key, instead of equals, I will use dot equals to, here I will use a stored key. So if we are teleporting in the same world, we say server player entity, we typecast the user to server player entity, dot network handler, dot request teleport. Now instead of target, we should say target.pose dot get x, and I will copy the same thing, comma, get y, comma, get z. That's our location. And finally, we can use target.yaw, and as the last parameter, target dot pitch. This will teleport us. However, remember, this works if we are teleporting in the same dimension and the same word. If we are teleporting between dimensions or any other means, we can say dot teleport to, and here we say target, and that works. And at the end, we just want to call the return super blah, blah, blah. Now make sure that we call it on the proper place, so we are not client, and we make sure that the data is not null here. So here, basically, we are not having any of this, and we just return super.use. And that's our player teleporter. Now, the parts that I wanted to show you was first making sure that we are checking if the NBT has the correct keys, and also this section. Because if you comment one of these two cases for the teleportation, you will get an error message, especially the top one. If you comment this and run the game and try to teleport, you will get a funny message, error message about network handling stuff. And that is because this is how you should teleport the player if the word is the same as the one that is registered on the key. If that's not the case, then you want to teleport between dimensions and between words. This is the new way of doing it. This will not work if you are teleporting inside the same dimension, because there is a network handler that needs to handle the teleportation. It took me a little bit to find about this code.
If you like these videos, please subscribe to the channel, hit the like button, and turn on that bell so that when I publish a new video, you will get informed. Have fun, everyone. Bye.